name is Kaiser Nani, and I'm coming to you today, here, broadcasting live from beautiful Top Lane. With me here today is Randy.
Hello.
And Ocelot, who has recently suffered a broken wrist.
That's a complete and total lie. I'll have you know, I got it injured in a bar fight at bottom lane. Don't go there, man. You'll get robbed.
Yeah, with Tusk, I assume. So,
mid's alright, though.
So, we have, I don't know what this means, the centaur. We have the chocolate eyeball.
It's Mars.
Raise,
it's just a pair of arms! It's a pair of arms!
I don't know how that happens.
No, no, go back to it and look at it. Go back to it and look at that statue and, like, first, like, the field view. Look at it. It's beautiful.
It's spooky.
It's just arms!
I think I like this statue the most, though. Just a stupid punch set.
I like how the hair isn't part of, like, the gold texture on it. Fuck it's just, man. Like, this... It's like someone just put a toupee on the pudge statue.
Kunkka just realized something. Let's see.
Oh, Kunkka walks funny because he's only one-legged.
Kunkka isn't missing a leg, my friend.
Wow, he is. I thought that was just going to be a,
I thought that was a cosmetic.
Yeah, I thought it was a cosmetic, but now that's just how he normally looks. Let's see.
Interesting.
Stanley for Apple. Of course, doesn't have the mega kill for him, so Fire Captain, why not?
Yeah, that'll match up really well.
That won't grit on your sanity, it just suddenly was just like, yeah, and here we have ourselves a double kill.
Rana just, like, dropped a bunch of items for no reason, that's good.
It's the drop your item meta, so you can lose.
So, team comps. Dire is, like, the first thing I noticed about Dire is that it's just really under-carried. Like, yeah, you got some technical carries there, like Void and Rana, but it's just, like, nothing I would really call anything of substance versus, you know, Sven, Kunkka.
Now, on that topic, I just like to...
Guys, they're laning together.
Oh, good.
You know, I'm glad,
Smunkka.
I'm glad Sven realized that the Dire was, you know, undercarried, so they decided to have support Kunkka.
What did Kunkka level as his first ability? Torrent, right?
Svunkka lane.
Yep. Axe is,
oh my god.
Getting
Axe, don't fight your illusion. They'll spin like mad.
Yeah, what was happening there? Uh-oh.
Axe was attacking his own illusions. Oh. Yeah, I was gonna say, Axe was attacking his own illusions, and, there's actually a reason that Manta Style is actually a pretty legit item on Axe, and that his illusions spin for full pure damage.
Well, part of the issue there was happening was, like, Axe was spinning, and the illusions were spinning because of it. It was kind of miserable.
No, it's actually only auto attacks that cause him to trigger there, and Counter Axe doesn't
trigger
that, which is weird. Yeah. Actually, that'd be a good buff to Axe, if you ask me, to make him spin on taking any damage at all.
That would just be... God, man.
Well, I mean, it's called Counter Helix for a reason, not just, like, fucking Parry Helix. Yeah, not just, like, Parry Helix.
I mean, Beaver, it should be Parry Helix. I'm not gonna lie, that would be ridiculous. Like, what if you, like, hit Lila's
Make it an Axe thing. Make it an Axe thing. I'd like that more, because if you imagine being the sad clown that gets Axe against, like, Lashrak and people who just, like, don't auto-attack ever.
Imagine getting Finger of Death as Lion you spin.
Just...
Right as you spin, so you take no damage. Imagine getting, like, you know, Sven walks up with R, just hits you with a super hard crit.
And I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of surprised that Counter Helix doesn't actually reduce the damage you take from the attack you counter.
Rubick is just kind of wandering around, not really doing anything of value at this point in the game, I've noticed.
Like, roaming Rubick, done wrong.
Yeah. Like, he's kind of focusing mid, but not enough to say he's there. And Bounty Hunter is just straight roaming, like, people do this, I don't know what. He got stats. Okay, no, I was worried for a second, but no. I don't know why people do this so early with Rubick. Like, the earliest I would just start roaming with Bounty. I'm sorry, not Rubick, it's probably about 4. Let's see if Sven still falls for it anyway. No.
No, I just like to...
No Janata.
I just like to point something out here, that... The Radiant has an absolute metric ton of stuns between Kunkka, Sven, fucking Invoker. God forbid Rubick or Axe get in the mix. That's just a big death ball of
just
stuns.
CC.
CC
the team.
Oh god!
What the hell?
Shattered even, please. That was intentional, guys. Intentional.
Yeah, it was absolutely intentional, even though he had like a TB scroll and like a windlace and could have died.
Gotta
die
for that windlace.
Like, no gold. Sacrificed almost all of his gold to do that, for whatever reason. Makes sense. Kunkka's just got boots. Yeah, I have a feeling they're gonna be some wacky starting. Where are you, Underlord? You're doing this,
Jungle
huh?
Lord.
You're
Jungle Lord.
Listen, you know, Underlord hasn't really been in the Dota 2 meta very long, and I will be the first to admit that I'm not an expert with them, but it seems like this is a really fucking stupid idea, and somebody paused to concur. Question mark? Where were we? Reading we're on a pauses, axe immediately on pauses. Glad you can do that in Dota 2.
Yep.
Now, ever since the addition of Iron Talon and a couple other items into the early game
Axe has an
items
iron
list, it's actually very viable to get Iron Talon on almost anyone, even for just laning and last hitting. It's a good item to have in general.
It's a good item to have, but definitely not something I would drop on if I wasn't planning to jungle. Luckily, Axe is tired of top and is now permanently jungling. If you have not noticed the issue with this quite yet, don't worry, you will soon enough.
Yeah, it's going to be in a big denouncement coming out across all teams of what is going on here.
Rubik and Bounty are just dancing around each other.
I don't know what's happening here.
Bounty's guessing which one's the real one. Which one's the real one? Which one's the real one? Gonna run out of invis time, Bounty.
Give a shit. She just arrowed like the creep lay straight. Doesn't
matter.
That's
a very
though.
Dead Rubik.
Gotta get that free lasted.
Correct. I don't know what he was thinking. Better stand in enemy territory for 9 years with Memphis here on the other team. Denied. Yeah, it's like, I don't know. Like, on Pitlord, I don't know if I would really be getting talons, especially against a Svunka lane, you know? This is where
Look at that. Oh, now Rubik's here. Yep. Rip. Underlord.
Oh god, the CC.
He's got a salve. He's got a salve.
And he's got a hell.
Fantastic passive. Yeah, he's got a windlace.
Ooh, he barely got out of there.
Yeah, that was close. Sven doesn't even have boots, that's why! What the hell? I've never seen somebody go this far for Dominator. What is the Radiant doing?
Although, truth be told, it is a good idea for him to stack amps this early.
Nobody cares! I was thinking at least Rubik would go up there, but no, nobody gives a shit. Radiant could give a fuck, alright? They couldn't give a fuck, and they tried. What the hell?
Haste.
Bounty got a haste. He's not gonna do anything with it. Run home.
I gotta ask. Does Sven have a stacked camp in any ancients yet?
Wait, kidding? Of course not. He's got the creep there, but hasn't stacked anything. Axe got tranks. I bet this is going to be unsurprising. You know, three videos in a row, but I just don't get why people do it. If you want to get, especially since all they do is this anyway, and he's bad at it. Like, if you really want to get some easy region in the jungle, Vlad's is actually surprisingly good on Axe. You know, gives you a lot more stats, a lot more viable stats. You can go almost, you can max into Battle Hunger if you have the thing and be fine, you know? Well, Sven just missed a stack. Void just killed Kunkka.
Congratulations.
Sven missed a stack and he's like, there is nothing there.
I think Void blew Chrono on that, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, he did. Down for a long, long, long time, but not like it matters.
On the topic of Axe and the Meadows, I've just felt like saying, you know what's a really murderous
thing is when Invoker Sun strikes the wrong way, even though he knows Bounty is not going to be retreating that direction, and when Axe dies because he doesn't know how to even juggle with these stupid tranks, let alone, oh god, he has some fucking raindrops too.
You know what's a really murderous combo that people really underestimate these days is Axe and Bloodseeker. Axe is blood rage by Bloodseeker, and next thing you know, he's spinning for like a million damage. Sure, he's taking a shitload, but then he starts pulling blading and getting all of his health back in the process.
That's pretty miserable. Speaking of which, Marana just got introduced to pulling blade the hard way.
Pulled.
Shadow Fiend's about to follow suit. Oh no, that was a bet.
Yeah.
Rip.
Kunkka was smart enough not to just draw Torrent on the first place he saw, which was pretty good on his part. If nothing else, get like an urn. An urn would do you a lot better than Trunks in this situation, you know? Like, I don't know, I just don't get it. At least it's not criminally offensive, and maybe I'm just saying that because I'm so used to it, because I can form no better argument for Axe Trunks than I can for Silencer or Bat, honestly, but still wouldn't do it. I really like Phase on him. I think Phase is criminally underrated on Axe. You can just zoom up to enemies. They just have to deal with you. You know?
Pretty much, yeah.
Bounty Hunter knocks out a ward. That was Sentry. Kunkka misses a torrent, but Rubik is quick on the draw, gets some more detection down, and Bounty just eats it.
Well played. Meanwhile, Void takes a tower.
One second here, I gotta touch something real quick. Great. Okay, we're back. Luckily, nobody sitting at home actually saw that because of the magic of OBS. Okay, so...
I thought...
They found his creep.
No, not the creep! Good lord!
Not Billy the creep.
Dyer's bottom tower.
This is supposed to be a dead underlord.
Actually hit that.
Unfortunately, though, no one followed up on
underlord,
it.
Underlord, are you stupid? Luckily, nobody's actually manly enough to follow up on that, so Underlord gets away with it.
Beat up the Forge Spirits.
Here comes Bounty Hunter.
Watch this. They hit him for like 3 damage. Watch, just 3 damage right click.
Wow!
I got him.
That's what you get for leveling up Shuriken. Is that in range? I don't think it is.
No, it's just barely outside the O.
Oh boy.
Boy, that's the wrong thing to do. You don't run around and think about hitting your target, you just hit your target. Every millisecond in Chronosphere matters.
And here comes the Rust to Dire for no reason. If only there was some way to get here faster, huh? Looks like Underlord blew his ult to TP out somewhere. Which is not what you do. Please don't jungle Underlord, and please don't waste your ult to just TP around when it has a 130 second cooldown. I think your TP might not be effective.
Honestly, I have found that most people would say that Underlord is countered by LC because of LC having straight late game progression like down the road and having a permanent source of damage, whereas Underlord gets very temporary large amounts of damage from just pushing creeps and, you know, killing people. But the thing is that what's weird is his ult, if timed right, can literally save you or your ally from a duel, which is what's something that very, very few heroes can do guaranteed.
Or in this situation, more accurately, it can make Axe a Sack Clown, Invoker in the Ice Wall. I mean, they all have heroes that are very dependent on the enemy just kind of sitting there for a little while. So Underlord's actually a pretty, you know, nasty choice against this lot.
Dire's top tower is being attacked. Especially considering that with...
That he could be doing
I don't even need to stress this sheer amount of damage that can be pulled off with his Firestorm attack along with Chronosphere or, God forbid, a full duration arrow.
Finn is buying up a bunch of random shit, presumably going for
Echo
Saber.
Yeah, I was going to say, I believe he's going to either Echo Saber or for some reason.
The Oblivion staff just looks like it's made of random garbage, you know? Doing some ancient camps here. I'm gonna take a quick look. Currently leading the board for last hits. Not doing so well on kills. As far as net worth goes, third place. It's probably higher after that.
Now, I'd just like to say that it's a strange thing to get on Sven of all people, but... You know, Echo Saber's great for that second immediate quick hit, which can really give you some just straight easy kills in the early parts of the game.
Well...
Oh,
but
please tell me this works.
No.
Rip.
But so what close. really What really goes south, though, for him, though, is when Echo Saber starts to tear off in the late game, where his attack speed just isn't enough. Where his attack speed is just too strong for the Echo Saber. You know, like, sure, the two quick attacks are nice, but it's just not as reliable as consistent attack speed down the line. Which is why I like to get myself a a Chrysalis into an Orchid, then straight into a Bloodthorn on Sven, because the consistent crits combined with the... speaking of combined... And there's the Firestorm.
Oh my god.
No Firestorm? Yep, there's a Firestorm.
Rubik,
look at that damage.
Just barely got out of that with Void's jump. And it looks like this was all for nothing. Nothing came out of this fight.
What level is Void and what level is Chronosphere? One? Two?
Yep. I'd assume
level
one,
10.
Yeah.
If he had at least level 2 Chronosphere, that Firestorm would have... Wait, hold on. Does he have max Firestorm? E or W?
Firestorm.
So it should have done more damage, but I guess it just wasn't long enough duration. They are bailing out. They are bailing out.
Well, two people are bailing out.
Sven just got a dominating streak.
Yeah, unfortunately, wait, what? What? Where did they TP to?
Oh god. Underlord, please.
What did you do?
He like TP'd the bot and then walked back and nobody cares.
No. Yeah, he like TP'd the bot with all of his friends. They all, both walked back and died.
He TP'd the bot with, I think, Void, and then Void got X'd back.
Good.
Which, I'll be very happy if that was the case for me.
Well played. You got a Aether Lens, alright.
Bounty Hunter is still not sick. Is there anybody else with that? No, he's the only hero who doesn't have his ult, and he's maybe one of the most important heroes to get an early ult in the game.
Yeah, no, roaming is a good idea, though.
Wait. Did you just say that... Hold on, did you just say that Underlord got the Aether Lens?
Yeah.
Yep.
Am I seeing things?
Underlens.
Look, okay, I get it. Underlord's got crap cast ranges on his first two abilities. But come on, you don't dedicate an Aether Lens to that.
Yeah.
Get yourself a Blink Dagger. Get yourself something that's better for like an initiation item. Like a god, I say that honestly. Fucking honestly, you want to get a Force Staff more than you want to get an Aether Lens. Sure, it's extra mana. Sure, it's extra regen that could go with your Atrophy Orb to make you really hard to kill with right clicks. But then the enemy just sort of... Yeah, that. Oh look, he blinked. What can he do about that? Well, he's out of your range now because he's really fast.
I don't think a Yules will be too bad on him either, especially considering he already bought the goddamn Windlace. Just on the grounds of, you know, playing Lina and just setting up your other abilities to just work inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
Just put a little Pit of Malice there for them to fall right down into. Make sure
Pit of Malice, it is instantaneous. It's still a good idea. I see what you mean by it.
Yeah, it's instantaneous, but it's so short range. It's like, right? You really want to risk that, and you really want to get spun to hell, because that's what just happened there. Wow. Bounty, you're making
Bounty.
Here. Bounty. Bounty, you don't want this.
Get him.
You may think
wards.
You want this, but you don't want this.
I know for a fact they've got wards, but I just don't think they care.
Bounty, listen.
Come on, go for that Sven. Go for him. Come on.
Go for Axe. Come on, man.
Oh, you tried to.
Oh,
he knows he's there if he's not stupid.
Did I just see a buyback? No.
No, that was just a normal one.
Kunk is in the trees too,
honestly,
my god.
Kind of a clusterfuck of a game if I do say so myself.
Just
Bounty's
about to meet his death. Oh.
They know. I
Bounty.
There.
Bounty. Oh no.
Just absolutely demolished. And by the way,
why would he stick around there? Just what was he waiting for?
At least he's finally hit 6. X has got his blade mail because he's playing Legion Commander, as you can see from his item set.
Was he just waiting for Rubik? Was he just waiting for Rubik to like get hit with like 3 Hadoukens from a Satyr on a row just so he could
kill
him?
The presumption was, I think, that he was waiting for them to not be 5 men, but it's the current
or
meta
maybe the
that's
courier.
Not happening.
Better the courier, but still.
Yeah.
I don't
way too risky.
Like, if he was going for the courier, he was even further barking up the wrong tree. Not like he's getting that in one shot, not like he's surviving to 2.
Yeah, because I don't think he has Janata, does he?
He does.
Or not high enough level.
Really shitty. Level 1.
Yeah, that's not gonna kill a courier.
Mac, you've got level 1 of Shinada and Invis because he hates living.
You know, gotta max that shuriken toss to steal kills.
Yeah, use all your mana and one shuriken toss and then just die.
Yeah, that would have been a good a few patches ago, but sure as hell not now.
Gold for my chest.
Here comes Marana, almost up to that eggs.
Halfway there, primary.
Oh no, not halfway there. All she needs is the Agi, and she's 714 gold. She's almost got it.
Oh, whoa, you're right. I just stuck that Mystic Staff for a infused raindrop for a second there. I just saw like this wad of blue, and I'm just like, ugh.
Void just sunstruck.
Speaking of a wad of, blue. What is your opinion on Io these days as a hero?
He definitely needs
buffs.
People
needs
who are.
More.
He needs
you
people
know,
who
I remember
good
when they nerfed. Yeah, I do distinctly remember when they nerfed Io, where they made it so that his little tether debuff was like. It used to be like a very brief mini stun.
Yeah, very brief.
I don't know if I'd want to go back to that. It is a tempting thing to say that oh, that's all he needs to be fine right now, but I don't know. Like, the big
I mean, Io is definitely a 5-sec hero.
Yeah, for one, he's a 5-sec hero. He just doesn't offer enough, you know?
Just,
you got
I think
global
you just
TV,
need to.
Which really doesn't matter the 5-man. Yeah. Boy gets another Sunstrike kill, it seems.
I think they just need to give him an Axe already. Most heroes are immediately fixed with the inclusion of Axe these days. Kunkka got brought back into the meta with the introduction of Axe.
Sven is
going
crazy. This is not gonna work out.
You just see that sick dodge by that Shadow Demon against that Sven, so that was something else. Well, speaking of something else, this Void's about to be something dead. Ooh, how many stacks do you have on him? Three? Four?
Three.
It's not enough to kill him.
Bizzle just showed up. Didn't take anyone with him. And this was yet another pointless stalemate fight.
Yeah, Underlord has a global TP that's a lot better than Wisps right now.
A lot better than Wisps, up about the
granted,
same.
Granted, it can only teleport onto allied creatures, and it requires a Dominator at the minimum, but man, deny the possibility just to dominate a creep, send it into the base, and just wait.
I mean, the thing is, right now, there's so seldom an opportunity when you want to be going somewhere. Well, for one, you don't generally want to be going somewhere alone with Io right now. If somebody's backing, that means that you've got about a 9 out of 10 chance that the rest of the team is also backing with them. So, teleporting in on what you think could be an easy kill is usually, especially if you've got Io, people are watching out for it, by the way, usually a recipe for disaster. Well, that's Lincoln's fear on the Faceless Void.
There goes all of his health back to full.
Yep. They don't care. They really don't want anything to do with this guy for some reason. I don't understand why.
Oh, Marana got eggs. Great.
That's bad for them. That is so bad for the Radiant, I can't even begin to describe.
Yeah, they're all, aside from Axe, well, even Axe right now is pretty squishy to magic damage because he's only built Fizz. Voker found that pretty funny. Yeah, he's got Blade Mail and a Vanguard, and then Tranks and an Iron Talon. So, two more armor on that Iron Talon. Kunkka smells blood, gets nothing.
Oh,
he does get something, which is killed.
Rip. But he did buy some wards.
Oh! Whoa. Axe is pretty strong right now, but unfortunately it won't save him.
Die.
And that's
luckily,
600 plus gold.
Something.
Sven smells blood, but he walks right into the pit of malice for his trouble and takes a shitload of damage from Marana's eggs.
What is your Sven made in
Void? Void,
please.
He tried to save their
god!
Oh, Sven is so unfair.
What is doing? Was that Sven doing that damage?
Yeah.
Sven just got 700 plus gold, or Marana even.
God.
What is Sven's items right now? I gotta know.
He's level 2
ult with crits and echo. Yeah, there you go. Crits, echo saber, and level 2 ult. That's an instantaneous death. There is nothing he could have done about that.
What the fuck?
Okay. Did Invoker just sunstrike Marana? Because she died.
Check the kill feed.
Yeah, let's find out. Looks like it, yeah. This Invoker is going to town with these Sunstrikes. He's been hitting a lot of them really well so far, and usually getting kills on him, so well on him for that.
You must watch a lot of Dendy streams.
Yeah, he's watching, Mr. Dondo.
It still reminds me of that rampage I saw a long while back where Danny's like, fuck them, please, come back, please, and please. And then just in the middle of the fountain, the runner goes like, say what now? And then suddenly just walks right into it. Rampage. He gets so excited, he jumps away from his keyboard and Saints rewards!
Yes. Oh my god. Dude,
it's so true, Saints spot. Rubick initiates for basically no reason.
Oh, I thought they were gonna get caught in that for- Oh, speaking of caught.
Oh god.
Sven's really strong, but Sven needs his BKB like bad. Oh.
Well, Sven needs to-
Oh, he walked on the meatball.
Sven needs to be smarter about initiating, because he, almost lost out on that kill outright from, Oh, hello, Marana. Oh, hello, Aldi. Our entire team is dead.
Oh, no. God.
Well, that was pretty bad for the fire. As I was saying, God. Sven's problem right now is that every time he tries to kill somebody, Shadow Demon makes them not able to be easily killed. Dire have
fortified their Sven really does need that BKB though. Like I said though, weird item to get on Sven, but Bloodthorn is so good.
This
it gives you an emergency CC, it gives you true strike, and on top of that, it absolutely ruins people.
This game,
try to just outlast you in a fight.
This game definitely would go for Daedalus. The way I see it, if you're going for like attack speed crit spam Sven, you want to go Daedalus. If you're going for if you're going to more of a balanced build, then you know you go for the Bloodthorn. But this guy is Speed City, so Invoker does not micromanage his fire spirits or his forge.
No, now that I think on it, this game, just because of the fact that he has, you know, a Kunkka on his team, I'd say that even though it's a really situational item, most people would say, get an Axe on Sven. It's a support-esque item, but you just make everyone else murderous. Like, Axe has really crap base damage, but his stack growth is really good. I mean, same goes for Invoker and even Rubick. I mean, crap, people start right-clicking so hard that Underlord's attribute aura won't even matter at that point.
Well, bad news for Rubick fans out there.
Oh.
Cover your eyes, children. Invoker gets caught out by Shadow Demon, but is able to respond before they can do anything about it. So that's a none-for-one trade. Precisely what Dire doesn't need right now. Radiant's building up here for a team fight. If they go in right now, they could just catch them completely off guard, which would be hell on earth for them. It looks like they're trying to go.
Oh boy. Sven smells a meal.
Bounty Hunter.
That
makes a right call there. Marana does not. But she blanks out anyway, so it's
really.
Yeah, she blanked out.
Yeah, she got out of there at lightning pace, my god.
This is yet another one of those classic games that I feel like is just going to be the blank goddamn factory. Radiant's middle tower is taking damage. Somebody
nothing's more.
Both teams right now really ought to get a Radiance on someone or somebody, because Blinks right now are just being a miserable fact of life for both teams.
You know, personally, I'd say the best carrier for it right now would be Axe. It's a bit of a counterproductive thing, because if you miss an attack on him, I'm pretty sure it doesn't have a chance to proc counter Helix. But at the same time, just the raw damage when people are forced to stand next to you like an idiot while you're chasing people down with the Bullet Blade, it's proper. Sven would also not be a bad. Sunstrike, too, my god.
Yeah, I'd have to concur there. The best Radiance carriers for. The best carrier for Radiant is no doubt Axe. For the Dire, I would say, is Underlord. He's definitely not in a place to build that, though.
Man, he's. Like, look, I get it. His Atrophy Aura is so good, and a lot of his base spells are pretty crap. But you don't want to build him full support. You get a couple support things, but you need to build him into something a bit more.
He's definitely pause four. He's not a guy who can subsist on no farm, you know?
Like, position five is where the support's belong. I'd say that he she's at least position four at the highest position two. Because he serves, in my opinion, best as a core, much in the same respect that, say, Tusk, or hell, even Axe would. Some respects, where he's got a good amount of CC, good damage, some kind of gimmick that just changes up how the game is going to be won, you know? Speaking of this, looks like
Friezel's Void is just bouncing off of Sven, and now he's out of here.
I was gonna say, Mirana just sort of tried to pelt them with her star call, but it didn't do anything. Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Ooh. Here comes the boat.
Boat!
Oh, oh god.
Nothing
oh,
came out of it.
God. Yaga.
Wrecked!
Oh.
Rip.
A ward! There's a ward there! Wow, what is that doing there?
I couldn't tell it.
Oh no. This Shadow Demon's doomed.
Goodbye, bounty. Flat.
Yeah. Boom.
Man, I are just getting cleaned up right now.
You know, have you ever, like, seen someone take so much damage in Dota, you just physically wince as if you could feel it yourself?
This whole game I've been feeling that- Oh, Rubik, the sick doggy. I know what he wants, but he's not gonna get it anytime soon. Wreck. God, it's just a massacre. Oh yeah, that's gonna do a lot, buddy. Come on back in, Underlord, the water's fine, and they'll be tainted by your blood soon enough. I'll stop the blood right there.
He's gonna hit Talon's way the inevitable, but he really shouldn't have fought back, because he's gonna get voted or something. He's almost got the mana for it.
And racks are down, time to clean. Yeah, that's gonna, go anywhere productive, Ronnie, you got her. Shit fucks. Thank you.
Oh.
I'm glad I talked good about you this game, so you could go on to be a complete retard. Being attacked.
Clear as clean water.
Clear as clean water for Kunkka. What we got here? I am this.
Oh boy, no.
He doesn't care. He doesn't give a shit. Oh, there we go.
Oh yeah, he does.
But if he goes in on this, if he goes in on this, he might not like what he finds.
Oh boy.
Kunkka, do something. Kunkka, do something!
Oh boy!
Kunkka!
My god! I just want to march while you die!
Where was all of his mana? What happened?
Basically
did
he nothing.
A creep?
I don't know. The better question is, where were the rest of Swin's teammates? Like, where was this man?
No mana regions in this place.
Oh, that arrow barely lifts.
Ooh, Axe is a Lotus Orb. Oh my god, the spins! Is being
attacked. Yeah, Lotus Orb, I'm not usually a very big proponent of Lotus Orb. I think it is kind of on the weaker side of things right now, but on Axe, it's hell. On Axe, it is really hell. Ah, barely with.
Oh, Dios mio.
Meatball!
Right when the Dire think they have a little bit of a turnaround, Radiant just comes back together and just slams them. It wrecked, bitch!
That's literally caps lock key. He hit shift to capitalize it, but it just swapped it because it's caps lock. A literal caps lock invoker.
Invoker is a funny guy. You should go to comedy school and work on his act. I think he could really be good, maybe at the age.
Well,
what are you doing?
Boom! Two creeps.
Well,
two
honestly, speaking of funny though about Invoker, if you really want to hear a joke, you should ask his mother's vagina, because the last thing that came out of it was one.
My god. This is why Kunkka's like got no mana all the time, he just keeps bolting for no reason.
Oh,
it's
so,
a creep lord skill. It's a
I just realized something. Sven's got his full Daedalus.
Yep, Sven's got full Daedalus. He's had that for a little while. Got Echo Saber. He's
I didn't notice. I just thought.
Oh, God.
It's hard to tell, honestly, because he already
what
hit so
fuck
fucking hard.
What are you doing, Underlord?
I think he's getting a Veil of Discord to boost the damage on his.
Ooh. Two men. I don't know if this is gonna. Oh, yeah, well.
Oh, my
oh,
God.
Oh, that is a lot of gold. Holy shit.
Yeah, that's 903 gold to Void and 575 gold to Mirana. That was a big, big, big one. Luckily, Kunkka was off doing some very important business.
Oh, what are creep waves?
What's wrong?
To be fair, the cooldown is low enough to support it, but
no,
at the same time...
it's low enough to support it if you have, like, an Octarine and it's level 3. Not when it's level 2 and full cooldown. That's just stupid. That's just, I don't want to contribute anything, Kunkka. The Rogue Knight wants to finish his AC, which is why he just hasn't been in these fights recently. As much as I love AC, it might have actually been good for him to warm up with just a straight-up Moonshard. Just to be a Sven machine gun.
Yeah.
Rubik picks up a gem. Bounty Hunter's not gonna be messing with them anymore.
Dire's bottom tower under fire.
Dire's bottom tower under fire. Bounty Hunter wants to do Roche. This is not going to work.
He's not gonna.
This really is not. It's not gonna fly. On the list of things, yeah, no, that's not happening. Radiant is surely on their way now because they saw all. Why'd they scan? They know they're in there. They know.
Scan the pit.
They saw, and now they're gone because Invoker scared them off. Unfortunately, Bounty Hunter has not read the items Rubik has.
Feed my axe and you're bound.
Oh my god. Voker got an Ocarine Core. Kunkka apparently blew smoke for no reason. Just
That's
like he
good.
Does every time he opens his mouth.
Huh.
The Dire have not realized that there's a gym going down here. Unfortunately...
Oh, two men. Kunkka, please!
Unfortunately for Floyd, that didn't just join Spence's stomp, that doesn't matter.
Hugh, then boat, Kunkka. Unless
the boat,
you have eggs,
wait.
Yeah, that was... Floyd just dancing around. Though I wouldn't say up if
what is that?
Drop. Okay.
What?
You know.
Somebody dropped it to pick up a gem.
My raindrop! Dead.
God, this is starting to go south for the Radiant real fast. They just can't pinpoint down. They're focusing on the entire life. No,
Rush. Oh, Pitamelis. Rip.
Where was Kunkka during all
damn near team life?
He got almost destroyed, wasted all of his spells and mana, and his
he's about to get actually destroyed.
Hey, you want to know why they lost that team fight? It's because Kunkka hit a boat on nothing.
Yeah. What are you doing, you stupid pirate?
Marana's getting juked.
Yeah, smoke right next to Bounty Hunter.
Smoke!
Correct. Mega
kill. That's a team wipe. That is an official team wipe.
Oh no, it's a team wipe plus one because Rubik respawned.
Yep.
Such a dilemma. Yeah, it usually doesn't go so well when
Yeah, such a dilemma. Walk to base or die.
Such a dilemma. Do we not get Void because we can't pin him down, or do we not get Void because we don't have any silences? I could have hit. And that now he's gonna get the Aegis. Someone's gonna get the Aegis. Marana.
Drop the gem?
Maybe that's not the thing to drop for it. Bounty Hunter picks it up though. Maybe a little better of a carrier. Well, Radiant has now, I believe, officially ceded their advantage. Yeah, it's almost all the way back down to zero for XP. And
yep.
On its way for net worth. In fact, I
recruiting.
Would not doubt. Couple of seconds here when it refreshes.
Creating a mountain here.
37-35. Void makes fun of whoever dropped the raindrop. There's a region here. What needs to happen? Well, first of all, the initiator from now on, it has to be Axe. He has to go in there and he has to get Void with his Q. If he doesn't, they're simply not going to win the fight. I would say it's time to go for an Orchid and or Bloodthorn, but that only would go on somebody who has an already, you know, not so crucial active like, honestly, again, Axe. Just to be able to knock out his minions. Kunkka has some horrible hatred against creeps. Like, I don't know what they did to him, but clearly it was scarring since he just loved
wasting his
abilities.
That is about to die again, I think.
Maybe.
Nope. I guess whoever has the gem isn't around.
Oh,
maybe
no,
he thinks the creeps are Tidehunter.
Oh, Bounty Hunter has a gem right now. So. Maybe he thinks he's fighting that team called No Tidehunter, and so he's got to eliminate all their legions, including the creeps.
Yeah.
Because he misinterpreted it, right? Instead of it being No Tidehunter, it was like No, comma Tidehunter. It was like, no, Tidehunter. Also,
yeah.
Somebody has a Lotus. Bounty has a Lotus. It's gonna be hell. Oh dear, that's gonna be unfortunate. So now there's officially nothing you can do about Void except just boot him out. Better not focus him through the entirety of the
Bounty, they can see you.
doesn't matter.
I was gonna say, I was expecting Invoker just to jump in and meatball combo him suddenly.
I'm glad Rubik decided to circle himself on the map with the world's largest non-circle. Perhaps that was Void, you never
Radiant's
know.
Bottom tower is being attacked.
I don't know why he thought he was the most appropriate hero to immediately respond to this. Nor do I know why everyone's just kind of running to top now. Meta,
Ethereal Blade, okay. God.
Uh oh. That's a dead.
Oh, Dios.
Yeah, dead
yeah, that is fair. That is fair right there.
Why use arrows? Or why use arrows when you can get away with just min range and your axe? Like, I really am not exaggerating when I say I don't really think arrow play comes into much use in Marana anymore. All you really need, because. Honestly, if I had to change one thing about Marana immediately, even before Ags, arrows should do more, like, less minimum damage and more maximum damage. The fact that you get, you know, 320 plus probably at least a couple units worth of damage just from firing the arrow makes it kind of stupid, even if you're not stunned for very long.
No, no, reinstate the bug where the arrow would do max damage and max stun.
Well,
that is a very dead axe.
Kadunk.
Marana, don't hesitate. You haven't Aegis, what are you doing? Now you're just gonna die and you didn't give an axe for it.
Teepee!
Axe is like, I have no time for such a thing. Meanwhile.
Okay, that was awful. Marana should have just gone with the Aegis death and gotten axe. Now he's back in his own base messing people up.
Oh boy,
well, that was a good boat.
Oh, he's got a Lotus Orb on him. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Well, so much for Void. Oh, God. This is a disaster for the Dire.
Oh, God.
They were finally making a turnaround.
Holy crap.
Run
so
is here.
Deadly. Such a deadly fight.
Radiant's top tower is under siege. Run is here, and if Invoker goes
what
down,
this
could be real bad.
Just stood
oh, God.
Whoa.
Radiant's top tower is being attacked.
Scrap over the gym. Oh my god, that was devastating, man. That was a brutal fight.
Radiant's top tower is
I'm actually going to see the recap. Yeah, look at that. That was not even that long. 8k damage for the Dire, or Radiant, and 5k for the Dire. Jesus Christ. If only this were available for it, huh?
Oh my god.
If only he had
god.
That skill. You know, to use Kunkka's Rum and, you know, maybe even hit somebody with it, but, you know, use this. Creep wave skill, basically. I can't tell you who has the advantage right now after that fight. I guess the charts might be able to. Currently, kind of in the Dire favor. Kinda. Net worth? Kind of in Dire favor. Somebody's dropped a gem somewhere. Kunkka just. It really bothers me. It really does, man. It's not hard. It's not a hard endeavor to clear creep waves as Kunkka. It's kind of his forte. He can do it with no items, basically. Speaking of no items, Void's been doing pretty good for items so far, but he needs just more key punch, you know? He needs something like a Mjolnir, or even a Battle Fury to spread the party around. Because right now, he's really good at beating down one dude, and that's it.
Yeah.
Just starting to, oh, hey, it's like he read my mind. Not sure what he's going to get rid of for that exactly, but he's got a maelstrom now.
Deep Eastland, but I guess.
That's a good idea. I can't see that backfiring.
Yeah.
Marana disappears.
He might just,
see you, Rubik.
Wait until he gets troubles. Fight, I guess.
Presumably. Let him watch real quick, see if there's anything crazy. Yeah, nothing here.
Where is it? Yeah, he ditched his TP for it.
Actually, I think he did just straight TP right now, so... Use it. Yeah, nobody's building is particularly money. Crazy. I don't know if Shadow Demon should have disassembled arcs to make the, Aetherlands, but... I guess, since there's already a Graze on his team. Beyond that, nothing too out of the ordinary. Put Truck S. So, can we just talk about how Axe's name means nothing? Truck S. I don't know. I couldn't guess a thing. Dire's charging in. They are hungry for another teamfight victory. And,
oh, one man Chronosphere.
There's the boat.
Coming in. Ooh. but nobody can get him. Nobody can get him in time for his
Poker narrowly escaped death.
Oh my god, barely.
Oh, the
barely
fade bolt finishes him.
Barely died out there.
Oh lordy.
Of course.
Ben might actually be dead here. Yep, he's dead.
They lost three just for Void, so that's definitely not so great.
Yeah, and Mirana is becoming more of a target than Void is at this point, honestly.
She has a dagger! Clown build!
Look, if you can instantly blow someone up in less than a second just by being next to them, that's pretty cool. Oh, comeback! No, Meatball. He doesn't have... Oh my god, that damage!
Nope, we're on a miss
here. She doesn't... Yeah, she does not have quite enough damage to kill Invoker yet, but... I just gotta say this, if Invoker had Meatball there... Yeah, I'd honestly do that too. I would honestly have done that too. Oh no.
Oh god.
Yeah, now,
just a moment ago, an axe went in. If, fun little fact there. Oh god. Oh boy.
Mirana's got hella rage. And, good lord, just took him home.
Rubik neglected to try and steal that, sadly, or did he get it? I didn't see.
I don't think so. He got nothing. Yeah.
Nothing.
He's got Blink and Force, which is technically, like, it's what you should do if you have to, basically.
That should help.
I suppose. I don't know if I would do it in this game. Besides Chronosphere, which you're not getting out of anyway, it's not like they have that many real, like, slows or hindrance, you know? Hmm. Well, Shadow Demon has, like, built his... like, reassembled his arcs into tranks, even though it's, like, 44 minutes, so he's not gonna have those for, like, more than 30 seconds before he switches off to travels. Mirana finishes... Yep. Or doesn't finish, but upgrades Daggett. I believe that's three now. Shadows are now taking us. Radiant scans a Roche bit again, because that totally works. Roche is just going
They should
to
probably bed. Add that to the tooltip if they want people to know without reading the patch notes.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Radiant wants to go, but it's just too late. It's just too late. Yeah, the only way this could go well, well, maybe if they're really unlucky in that happens, but not that. Guys, kill it. Guys, kill it.
Oh, Void. Oh, Void, please.
Aegis is on the ground, you got
Snatched
it.
Snatched by Invoker. God.
That was
that is
bad
disaster.
On
What is on the ground right there? What is that on the ground?
Force staff.
Oh no.
That was...
I think Sven got it. I think it's on Sven. Whose force staff is that?
No, Sven doesn't.
So,
I believe that's Invoker.
Well, whose was it? Oh, that's a...
No, it's not.
Oh, he got it!
That was. So, yeah. That was
he
really
went back
bad
and got
for
it.
Boy. He hesitated
that was a
hard.
Disaster.
Hardcore on that. Why did Sven just drop his Dominator in the middle of the goddamn lane? What the hell was that?
It's a... You see, it's a new strat. It's called the Leave Your Items on the Ground So You Lose strat. It was perfected by Ice, I think.
Back to port.
God, look at the damage.
Oh
that
my
did.
God, that Invoker wasn't even E-bladed there. He's almost.
Oh,
uh-oh.
Boy.
Oh.
Off goes the weasel.
Kunkka boats like nothing!
Kunkka boats, and he doesn't know how it works, so he
there's
just shoots ahead by a country mile.
This Kunkka.
Yeah. Kunkka would have done better if he had Nags this game, not gonna lie. Just straight up, would have done better with Nags.
No, he wouldn't, because he just wastes his bolt all the time anyway. What good would that have done him? Sven is
well,
pissed,
at the, at the very
no
minimum,
ability to affect the situation is in fact dead.
At very minimum, the boat wouldn't fly past his target by a country mile. Also,
I mean, that was the one boat he tried to drop on a player this entire game, and he whiffed it. Ben. Hey, Sven got a BKB. Late, we got it.
Oh, Lord. Haste. I think I just realized something. Could you look over to the level differences? Well, I think someone in this game is already,
25? Yeah, Mirana's 25.
Yep. I'm saying, who's the super low level in this game, and take a guess who it is?
Rubik is 16.
Yep. Rubik and Bounty are both super low level. Speaking of, Bounty nearly died to something. Bounty actually died.
The
good
two
God,
quote unquote roaming heroes at the lowest level. What a shock.
Roy, Axe is asking to die.
But nobody is in the mood to deliver. And Shadow Demon gets abandoned. Shadow Demon gets left for dead. Brenna's push ability is insane right about now. Underlord is tired of dealing with your bullshit and has decided to buy an entire pipe of insight from scratch. Okay. Sure.
Look, Underlord is really versatile with his build, but you really should consider that. Maybe if you build him a bit more tanky than just supporty, then you might do a bit better. I mean, hell, you get a Crimson Guard, a Veil of Discord, and what else can you get on him? Hell, getting a Solar Crest on him is a great idea, too.
Rubik has learned nothing about kills while trying to ward. Yeah, definitely this is not the game for him
to get that.
Portrait of a dead Kunkka.
Oh man. Sven's thing is
brutal.
Dodged twice over.
Void
needs the Q.
Void just has.
Oh my god.
Void barely has any time to jump on the ground.
Yep.
Void barely has any time to react to that.
Is Mirana's kill streak still intact? I think it is.
Oh, it's bad for her if it is.
That is so much gold.
Oh, Axe, don't Culling Blade yourself!
No.
I was gonna laugh my ass off if Axe Culling Bladed himself right there.
Holy shit!
And
Boker,
you need the meatball!
She fucking made it! She actually did it! This is Freak Show! Dire's Ancient is.
Murana, please!
Murana not only escapes death, but saves the fucking game
Holy
by a skin of her teeth!
Shit! That was close.
How did that happen?
Okay, I don't think we've had a goddamn play of the game there, but just Murana.
That's all I'm saying to that is. Yeah, that's good.
Nice. Got him.
Here comes a shitty boat! It did nothing!
Void compromised his push with that.
Oh, Void, don't run to the meatball, my god.
Oh, they won.
Void just ruined that move.
Oh, Calling Blade, there's the gem again.
Void completely ruined that push.
The Shadow Demon just boned.
Tornado time.
If you say so.
Murana and Underlord now alone spend the father. Murana leashes her dagger on creeps, but Invoker is too hesitant to do anything about it because he's like 14 or whatever. This is really something right about now. Basically everybody's 6 slot. There are 2 gems in play on Radiant right now. Okay. One on Axe, one on Rubik, because that's what you need. It's 2 gems.
Shadow
side by
skin.
Side. Yep. Luckily, Murana hit ult, even though that's basically useless right now. Zap! And that's 1 gem down. Nobody can get Murana. Yeah, nice boat! Wow, it actually got her, but it did like 2 damage.
Oh, she might be done. This game might be over, boys.
Does she have buyback? Yes, she has buyback.
Camerana, save it. Camerana, save it. Let's find out.
Come on.
Boom. Boom.
Oh, you bleed.
Boom. Getting it.
Oh,
getting
GG.
It.
Not
boom.
Enough.
Holy shit. Well, that was a lot better of a game than what we usually cast.
Yeah.
I can't call anybody but Kunkka a complete idiot this time around. Fucking
My
hard.
God.
Yeah, you got that right. Whew, well that was really something.
Alright, first and
definitely
foremost.
Ready for some good Dota.
I just gotta say, first and foremost, This is the first game we've had a general play of the game right there. That went to Mirana's epic escape and saving of the Ancient. Though in the end it didn't matter, that was still pretty damn impressive.
Yeah, that was good. That was really good. Again, aside from... And I guess Bounty Hunter too, but to be fair, Bounty Hunter was Chinese playing on what's inevitably a US server, so he had 3 million ping. Pro tip, don't connect across two continents. Yeah, aside from Kunkka and Bounty Hunter, everyone played really well this game. Shadow Demon was really good on getting saves out with his little orb with Disruption. Mirana and Void were just like the tag team combo of the Dieters, making a mockery of the Radiant. And then on the other hand, you know, when the Radiant were in play, right? Anderlord just did okay. Nothing great.
Actually, no, hold that thought. I would like to say that Underlord earns a very specific and once-in-a-lifetime medal, the I don't know what the fuck I'm doing award.
Yeah, I don't really understand how this hero's going to work, because nobody really does right now, but I'm going to try and play him anyway, and jungle with him and shit. As for Radiant Axis, he was just balling through the whole game. Even if you're going to get them, I still wouldn't recommend it. I wouldn't exactly say it's complete
travels
shit,
are better in the late game.
But you need
travels
travel,
so much
yeah.
better for the late game.
Especially if you don't have a team as well. Aside from that, though, item choices are pretty good. The Lotus Orb in particular really saved his bacon a lot this game, and also came in handy for his teammates a couple of times. Rubick did fine, but was a little hesitant to steal spells sometimes. Invoker is 14. And Sven did pretty well. Especially, he was smart enough to take... One issue I see with a lot of, especially people who play Sven, is they'll get like a big advantage early game, and then they won't press it. But this guy was actually really good on, I'm ahead, I'm in the lead, I'm killing Void in like one hit, it's time for me to party, it's time for me to mess these dudes up. So, well on him for that. So, overall, Sad Clown of the Game Award, I don't think Kunkka for not realizing that Boat is a teamfight skill and not a push skill. No one sentence summaries this time, because I don't think anybody really deserves it. Closing comments, Randy?
No, that was a fail, Boat.
Ocelot?
I just got one thing to say.
What's that, Chief?
One person in this game tried so hard above all else and just got completely ruined for it when he really didn't deserve it.
Tried
and that
so
in its entirety...
Hard.
Yeah,
got
so
far.
Don't do it.
But in the end...
It's Shadow Demon.
Yeah, Shadow Demon was doing real good, I noticed. Like, he was...
It's sad, though, because for a hero who has some of the strongest purge abilities and overall damage potential in the game, he has just no escape power on his own. I mean, sure, he's got a blink dagger, but the second he gets much as a tick of damage, God forbid a DOT, you are just... fated to die in a team fight.
I don't think
you get a four staff, you're just slowed to hell.
I think the only two people who I could say really did bad at this game, and only really one of them, Bounty Hunter just did bad. Just didn't really contribute much at all. The only guy that I could really say did anything really bad this game was Kunkka, and he was still not offensively so. Like, tolerable bad random tier stuff. So with that, hope the next match is like that, eh?